fifth graders. I'm Trent. In the fifth grade, you need to learn math concepts for many reasons. Concepts are big ideas. Understanding the big ideas will help you do well on the AIMS test, get better grades in math, and prepare you for math classes in the future.
Plus, it is fun to solve problems and use parts of your brain you have never used before. When I solve a challenging math problem, it makes me feel great. I know the more I learn now, the brighter my future is. My name is Alexis. Let's get on with the show. We hope you enjoy
What's the Big Idea?
The big idea of this video is order of operations. In life, doing tasks in the correct order make our lives easier. We put on our socks before our shoes. In math, doing operations in the right order is important too.
Sometimes we see math expressions that have more than one operation. You can simplify the expressions by using the order of operations. If you follow the rules of order of operations, you can simplify any given expression, even if it looks confusing.
Before we get started with the details, let's bring in our talented and knowledgeable MVP, Jonah, the math vocabulary person.
Word, or should I say words. Let's look at a few of the key math words used in this video math lesson. Order, operation, expression. All three of these words have multiple meanings, but we want to use the meanings to help us understand the big idea in this math lesson. Order means sequence, going from first to last. Operations refer to the four math operations used for computation. Multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction are the four operations that we use to compute number expressions. Finally, a math expression is a value with numbers and symbols that does not include an equal sign. 3 plus 4 is an expression. 5 times 4 minus 2 is another expression. Remember, math expressions do not have equal signs. Have fun using order of operations. Now back to Trent.
Thanks, MVP. What operation should you do first? And an expression like 2 plus 18 divided by 2 minus 4 times 2. Here is one basic rule. Multiplication and division should be done before addition and subtraction. Some teachers have their students add parentheses to avoid confusion. If you enclosed 18 divided by 2 and 4 times 2 with parentheses, then you know for sure what to do first.
Of course, an expression is read from left to right, like sentences in a book. Let's go back to our example. 2 plus 18 divided by 2 minus 4 times 2. The first operation we perform is 18 divided by 2. The second computation we complete is 4 times 2. So our new expression reads 2 plus 9 minus 8. After we add and subtract, our final answer is 3.
If you add 2 plus 18 first, you get the wrong answer. That's why you need to learn about the order of operations. If there are no parentheses, divide and multiply before you add and subtract, reading from left to right.
Let's try another one. 10 minus 4 divided by 2 plus 6 times 3. Work quietly with your neighbor and figure out the answer.
Okay, let's see if you used order of operations correctly. If you divided and multiplied first, then subtracted and added, your final answer should be 26.
Parentheses or brackets should always be completed first in expressions that have them. 4 times 6 minus 3 divided by 2 plus 4. To solve this expression, subtract and add first. Hopefully you see that your final answer would be 2.
Thanks for your attention. Using order of operations to simplify expressions is fun. Practice makes perfect.
What's the big idea? Order of operations.
Learning fifth grade math, big ideas, is awesome. We appreciate your attention and hope you like this video.
Math rocks. For Trent and MVP Jonah, I'm Alexis. See you next time on
What's the Big Idea?